The future of space exploration is pure lunacy. It's been 43 years since the last human being set foot upon the moon in 1972. Heck, until the Chinese rover Jade Rabbit made a landing in December 2013, a human vehicle hadn't made a soft landing on that surface since 1976. What happened? We used to dream about the moon. We had moon fever. What happened was NASA turned its sights away from the moon and toward Mars and near-Earth asteroids. Fortunately, some people still dream of the moon. Today, we have the technological capability of getting there. It just requires the will to do it. And by that, I mean someone's got to pony up the cash. Luckily, there are several organizations that are considering going back to the moon. Some are in Russia or Japan, and there's the European Space Agency. All are interested in moon colonization. So it might end up being an international project, or it could end up being a private venture. Either way, I'm totally stoked. So let's take a look at how a lunar base might work. Anyone trying to establish a long-term habitat on the moon has some big obstacles ahead of them. The moon has next to no atmosphere, meaning the colonists would have no protection from deadly space radiation or the shotgun blast of micrometeoroids falling from above. However, a recent discovery from NASA's Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter camera may have a potential solution. The surface of the moon is covered in pits, lava tubes, so potential colonists could go down one of these tubes and build a habitat under a protective overhanging of rock, which would shield them from any radiation or bombardment from micrometeoroids. The polar regions are also popular places for potential colonies, for multiple reasons. For one, they have advantage over equatorial areas because the lunar day is about 29 Earth days long. That means if you're near the equator, you're going to get 14 straight days of sunlight, followed by 14 days of darkness. But if you locate your colony at the peak of one of the poles, such as at the Shackleton crater at the moon's south pole, you get permanent sunlight, which is perfect for that solar farm you're building. Plus, the poles may have water ice. And as we know, in space, water is more precious than silver or gold. Not only can you drink it, but you can use it to make rocket fuel or breathable oxygen. One thing we might want to consider wherever we decide to plant our moon colony is inflatable habitats, like those created by Bigelow Aerospace. These are sturdy, airtight environments, and it would mean that we wouldn't have to build something on the surface of the moon or ship heavy, rigid structures from Earth to the moon and hope that they get there safely. But one big challenge of colonizing the moon is the dreaded moon dust. It's clingy. It's abrasive. As Hayden Christensen would probably say, it gets everywhere. Come to think of it, it's a lot like Anakin Skywalker, being both clingy and abrasive. US astronauts said it smells like gunpowder. This stuff could clog up machinery, and you certainly wouldn't want to breathe any of it in. And this is a problem we haven't completely solved yet. We might use some modified vacuum cleaners or a really advanced filtration system to help deal with the gray menace. The moon offers a lot of advantages you might not have thought about. For one, the regolith on the moon could be a healthy source of helium-3. Now, helium-3 could be a fuel for safe, clean nuclear fusion reactors. On Earth, helium-3 is incredibly scarce, but that's not the case with the moon. The moon also could act as an amazing observatory. Radio telescopes are awesome, but we've got a lot of radio chatter here on Earth that can act as interference. One place that doesn't have a lot of chatter? The far side of the moon. Plus, we could use the moon as a staging ground to test skills and processes and equipment for colonization throughout the solar system. After all, Mars is months away, so if there's an emergency, that's a real problem. The moon is closer to 3 or 4 days away. It's a lot more attractive. I've got a question for you guys this week. Do you think we should establish a lunar colony, or should we just skip that step and go straight to the red planet? I really want to hear your thoughts in the comments below. Thanks to Toyota for sponsoring this show and making it possible. If you enjoyed this episode, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and then blast off to check out these amazing videos over here.